England skittled out for 77 in first innings collapse as West Indies pace quartet take control. Was this really 2019, or had we been transported back to the Caribbean glory days of the 80s when West Indian pace ruled supreme and England were battered time and again? Sadly for Joe Root, this was no bad dream. It was all too real. England were embarrassed by world-class fast bowling at the Barbadian fortress of the truly great West Indies teams and are already facing a humiliating defeat to begin a series they were expected to win comfortably. England had no answer to pace, hostility and, crucially, bounce as Kemar Roach, Jason Holder, Shannon Gabriel and Alzarri Joseph gave passable impressions of Marshall, Garner, Holding and Roberts to send Root's side crashing to 77 all out. Only the sight of the majority of spectators at this famous old ground supporting England told you that this was very much a modern West Indian test crowd experiencing a very old-fashioned and quite thrilling demonstration of proper fast bowling. An eventful second day saw 18 wickets fall as West Indies collapsed to 61 for 5 in their second innings, with 3 of them falling to Moeen now. They reached 127 for 6 by the close. But the damage had been done. England are 339 behind and need a miracle if they are to avoid a repeat of their defeat here 4 years ago. The only difference is that you can't substitute Colin Gray's mediocre comments that inspired West Indies with Jeff Boycott's average and ordinary cricketer's faux pas now. We have, of course, been here before in the Caribbean. Like when Mike Atherton's side were rushed out for 46 by the last great West Indian side in 1994 and when Andrew Strauss's reign got off to a shocker in 2009 with 51 all out in Kingston. But we did not expect this, not when England were supposed to have enjoyed a watershed away success in Sri Lanka and West Indies were seemingly in yet another trough of test despair that has seen them slump to 8th in the ICC rankings. West Indies, inspired by a return of 5 for 17 in 11 overs from Roach, all 5 of them coming for 4 runs, were brilliant with the ball and led impressively by Holder, who has molded a tight-knit team in the face of 2020 defections. But England should be much, much better than this and are still prone to collapses when their positive brand of cricket leads to a lack of application and explodes in their faces. Not that they can blame their gung-ho approach for this calypso collapso. The majority were undone by skill rather than submission, with Rory Burns and Johnny Bairstow both perhaps unlucky to play on and Ben Stokes unfortunate to be the victim of a marginal LBW. Only Moeen, with an irresponsible, top-edged attempt to pull his first ball from Roach was truly culpable in his own demise. The rest simply buckled in the heat of the Barbadian kitchen. England, of course, have not helped themselves and can now be said to have got their selection very wrong. They agonized over leaving out Stuart Broad and going with 2 spinners and it was understandable they wanted Sam Curran in their side. But there were many, such as our own Nasser Hussain and David Lloyd, who said England could not afford to omit their tallest bowler on a ground where pace, bounce and aggression have always been king. They were spot on without the benefit of hindsight. Broad away from the ground on Thursday, a move England insisted was more to do with encouraging squad players to get away from work on batting days rather than because of his obvious dismay at not being picked here. But he can justifiably be angry. Equally, England could say the attack, led by a 27th Test 5-4 from Jimmy Anderson, equaling Sir Ian Botham's record, did their job in bowling West Indies out for 289 first time when this much talked about Kensington Oval surface was at its slowest. When Keaton Jennings was out fishing outside off stump to a full-length delivery from Holder it looked as though he would be at the centre of England's inquest. Instead his 17 turned out to be the highest score of the innings. Every cloud and all that. Then the mercurial figure of Roach, now 30 and with 50 tests behind him, took over to devastating effect, switching to the Worrall, Weeks and Walcott stand and after lunch and intelligently using a crosswind that brought the ball back into the right-handers. Bizarrely, the speed gun here suggested that only Gabriel exceeded 90 miles per hour and that Roach was bowling no faster than Curran at times. Surely some mistake. But even if he wasn't truly express pace he had the height and bounce to fatally wound England. All 10 England wickets fell for 54 and 21 overs after lunch as West Indies earned a surely decisive lead of 212 but decided against enforcing the follow-on. Had they done so, it is conceivable they would have won on Thursday, but instead they would have been concerned when Moeen dismissed Darren Bravo and Roston Chase in three balls. But by the close, West Indies were nearly out of sight. 46. Kingston, 1994. One of England's worst ever days, if not the worst. Having made 328 in the first innings, thanks largely to 86 from Graham Thorpe, England thought they were in the game chasing 194 to win. They were wrong. Just Alex Stewart made double figures, 18, in a complete dismantling, led by Curtly Ambrose, 6 for 24, and Courtney Walsh, 3 for 16. 51. Kingston, 2009. England were rebuilding after the ignominious end to the Kevin Pietersen and Peter Moore's partnership, but this show gave no hint of the successes they would go on to enjoy under Andrew Strauss and Andy Flower. Pietersen made 97 in a first-up 318 all-out, but England would lose by an innings and 23 as only Andrew Flintoff made double figures in a terror outing, Jerome Taylor taking 5 for 11. 103, Kingston, 1935. Not a collapse of modern era standards, but a poor showing regardless. Replying to 535 for 7 declared, England were up against it when they were all out for 271. What followed was worse. Wally Hammond top scored with 34 as Manny Martindale ripped through England with 4 for 28. 107, Port of Spain, 1935. Martindale went without a wicket on this occasion, but his teammates did the damage as England crumbled badly again. They actually made it to 53 for 1, but when David Townsend was dismissed, the floodgates opened. Townsend's 36 was an innings high as the hosts won by 217 runs. Press Association.